It's not always easy to make a high quality voiceover when you're at home or away from a studio. So in this beginner tutorial, we'll walk through how to use Entrap Studio to record spoken vocals on mobile using the phone's built-in microphone. And we'll also show how to do the same using an external microphone. We'll then break down how to add Entrap effects to process the raw recording into something that sounds more polished and professional. This video will be particularly useful if you record or are interested in recording podcasts, interviews, narrations, voiceovers, or vocal tracks in general. Hi guys, Matt Vertel here from Entrap. We'll be using Entrap Studio for iOS in this video, though as ever, the same techniques will apply on Android as well as the Mac and Windows desktop versions of Entrap. The most important decision that will affect the overall quality of your recording is where you decide to record your vocal. Many professional voiceovers are recorded in specific sound-treated studios, and if you don't have access to a space like this, you can still create clean, crisp-sounding recordings in a room with little to no background noise. You could try to record in a small bedroom or even something like a closet so that there is no room reverb or external sound that may end up in the recording. Let's try to record with the iPhone microphone. With Entrap open, we'll make sure that an audio track is added and arm the track for recording by activating the red button on the track. When clicking on the arm button, we'll see a menu. We'll make sure that mono iPhone microphone is selected, and if you have more than one input device connected, this is where you can choose which input device to use for recording the track. If we want to monitor the input signal, meaning to hear our input signal as we record, we'll enable the live input button on the track. In this case, we'd strongly recommend wearing headphones when recording to avoid any unwanted feedback noise and to stop any echo to be recorded onto the audio track. Our track is now ready, so we'll go ahead and press record. This is a test recording. This is a test recording. By way of an example, let's compare the iPhone microphone with an external microphone, the Shure MV88 iOS mic. One advantage of using the Shure is the included pop filter, which helps to reduce popping sounds when saying strong syllables during the recording process. We'll plug in the external microphone to the iPhone. Let's compare the Shure take with the device microphone recording so you can hear the difference. This is a test recording. 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 You'll notice that on both takes, we can hear the same faint background noise. So let's now switch gears to the processing of the vocals. We'll add the Entrap DEnoiser effect. It can learn our background environment and actually reduce the amount of that background noise. So let's adjust the DEnoiser settings to taste. Opening the track mixer, we'll click Add Effects, press the plus button and select Entrap, which will show us all the Entrap effects. We'll scroll down to DEnoiser, and then we'll close DEnoiser, select our loop range, click the loop icon, and press play. This is a test recording. We'll open up DEnoiser, select the preset bar, and choose background hiss. This is a test recording. We'll then adjust the amount of noise reduction from the plugin. Recording. We can also monitor noise, which plays the reduced noise only. This is a test recording. We have a tutorial video specifically for DEnoiser, so be sure to check that out if you want to get into a bit more detail. And for comparison, here's the device vocal recording before.
This is a test recording. This is a test recording.
And after applying DEnoiser.
This is a test recording. This is a test recording.
We can then boost and cut certain frequencies to shape the tone of our voice. Let's open the N-Track EQ and audition a couple of the presets. So let's choose vocal clarity.
This is a test recording. This is
male voice.
A test recording. This is a test recording. This is a test recording.
And podcast vocal.
This is a test recording.
From here, we can tweak the EQ nodes to further refine our voice tone.
This is a test recording. This is a test recording.
To get the dynamic level of the vocal more consistent, let's add a compressor. This will boost the loudness of the vocal and increase the punchiness by reducing the volume of louder sounds and amplifying quieter spots. We'll choose the compression preset from the N-Track compressor plugin.
This is a test recording.
And let's hear the difference before.
This is a test recording.
And after.
This is a test recording.
This is a somewhat finer detail, but if there are still moments in which the recorded vocal feels too loud or quiet in comparison to the rest of the track, we can use volume envelopes to adjust specific parts. Again, there's a more in-depth tutorial video on how to do this that we'd recommend that you check out, but to make the automation visible, we'll select the widget from the toolbar. We'll tap to create nodes. We'll zoom in. And then move the inner nodes to -2 dB. Playing this section back, we can hear that the automated part sticks out less in the context of the overall vocal.
This is a test recording. This is a test recording.
In general, it's good practice to keep a voiceover with little to no reverb so that it sounds crisp and clean. But what if you want to actually bring attention to a sense of space? In this case, we can load N-Track's ConvoVerb Reverb plugin and choose a preset that can help to serve that part of the narrative. For example, if part of a story centered around the church or a concert hall, the corresponding preset could be selected to help the listener hear a particular location.
A test recording.
And if you want to add reverb to only a section of a track, you can simply slice a track and then drag the slice section down to add a new audio track and add reverb to that new track.
This is a test recording. This is a test recording. This is a test recording.
Let us know how you're getting on recording vocals in N-Track Studio in the comments, and if you have any other questions. Also, please give this video a like, subscribe as ever so we can keep the channel growing, and hit that notification bell so you know when our next video is out. As ever, have fun making music and recording vocals in N-Track Studio. Until the next one, cheers.